They say the meek will inherit the earth. I am here to tell you that patsies will inherit the animals. I'm going to Uganda for 2 months. Could you take care of my gerbils? I see you already have parakeets, a ferret, and that king cobra over there. Sure. Thus it was that, patsy that I am, I inherited 3 goldfish. What could be so hard? They lived in a barrel with a water pump that sent water up a tube inside a decorative metal waterfall, out a cave, spilling through the air to splash back into the barrel. The whole thing had been brought over and set up in my bedroom. Goldfish grow to fit the size of their container, my friend said. So you see, these are pretty big. You feed them once a week. Here's the can with food pellets. Bye. I never owned goldfish before. These 3, sitting in the barrel on the floor, looked up at me expectantly. I read the instructions on the food pellet can. Feed fish 3 times a day, as much as they can eat, in 2 minutes, it said. I decided on a compromise. I would feed them once a day in the morning. Also, I would feed them if they suffered through any sort of trauma, which moving to my house certainly must have been, and if they came to the surface and looked at me expectantly in the evening. So I fed them. In the container, there were food pellets. I sprinkled some into the barrel and they floated around. The goldfish came up and started sniffing around, or did what looked like sniffing around. They swam vigorously around under the pellets, then occasionally put their mouths up out of the water and made the puckering thing with their lips. Then they would swim down to the bottom. I figured they liked the fish pellets, although nobody had eaten one. I figured correctly that they were scouting around, looking to see what else there was, and that they would be back to gobble them up soon. I waited. 5 minutes went by, and then they were back, or at least one of them was back. He put his mouth out of the water and did the pucker thing, and then he moved around a bit, still doing the pucker thing, until it seemed almost by chance that a pellet got puckered over and down his throat. He went off. He came back. Most of the time when he went off and came back, he'd be sticking his mouth up and not getting anything. The pellets were drifting around. What it made me want to do is pick a pellet up with my fingers and drop it in his mouth, but I didn't. Instead, I just watched. The fish was taking a long time to get anything, but he kept at it. Over the next 5 minutes, he tried and tried, but didn't get another pellet. He had these big eyes, but they apparently couldn't see the pellets. So he would pucker over here and pucker over there and nothing would happen. I thought this is going to take a very, very long time. But then I thought, well, he doesn't have very much of anything else to do. And so I went off. That evening I came back. The pellets were gone. The fish, however, gave no indication they had eaten them. No rubbing of their bellies, no smiles on their faces. There was, however, one of my dogs, a Wheaton Terrier, another inheritance, that was lying on the rug nearby looking very contented. I could add 2 and 2. I didn't feed the fish any more that first night, since it was just speculation on my part that the dog had been part of the scenario, but in the morning, I fed them again, and it was clear to me that the dog could indeed put his front paws on the lip of the barrel and get his head in there for a bit of a snarf. And he did have a very alert look on his face as I dropped the pellets in the water. I chased him out and closed the door, fed the fish, and left. When I returned home that night, the door was still closed and the pellets were gone. One presumes they got to the fish. I fed the fish this way for 2 weeks until the pellets were out. Then I took the empty container to the pet store. They couldn't match it, but they did have another container by another manufacturer. It said goldfish on the front. I bought it, took it home. Then I read further. They were shrimp pellets. Give them as much as your fish can eat in 5 minutes, 3 times a day. I screwed off the top and saw that there was a safety seal below it that you had to peel off. I found this very amusing, as in, maybe some impurity would get in there, or maybe a madman would come along and poison my goldfish. Well, now I could be sure, I thought, as I peeled the safety seal off, just shrimp pellets. It occurred to me later that day that only someone very wealthy would find it important to have safety seals on fish food. I didn't remember what I had paid for this container, but it was shrimp, and that could be pricey. Maybe I should go back to just regular pellets and give the goldfish shrimp as a treat, or on Thanksgiving, for instance. After all, if this were not a man-made barrel situation, and the fish were in a natural pond somewhere, they'd get whatever landed on the surface. A pigeon could fly by and poop on them, for example. I guess they could sort it out. The next day, I came home with another brand of goldfish food, something without the safety seal, which was called fish flakes. This seemed like such a good idea to me. The flakes would float on the surface of the water just like leaves might float on the surface of a pond. I sprinkled them in, then I took the Wheaton by the collar and I left. When I came back without the dog just a few minutes later, the flakes were all slowly sinking to the bottom, passing among the fish. Manna from heaven. But the fish were oblivious to it all. One day I came home to find that the waterfall had tipped over, that the hoses going to and from it had become disconnected, and that one of the fish was dead. I found him on his side, lifeless under the waterfall apparatus. It seemed he had been pinned down there, unable to get out for the day. What a horrible way to go, I thought. On the other hand, his body proceeded to drift out. He wasn't pinned there after all. A natural death. I scooped him up in a glass, looked at him carefully. There were no apparent injuries. He had probably died of fright. Terrible. Or maybe not. Maybe he had died of old age. I thought briefly about taking him out back, digging a hole, saying a little prayer, and burying him with a little wooden cross made of toothpicks on the top of the ground. But it was a freezing cold winter's day, the kind this fish would have loved, I knew, and the ground would be frozen. This was not to be. Then I thought about eating the fish. I could cook him up in some oil. A terrible idea. In the end, I flushed him down the toilet. Such a big thing. I thought he might clog it. He didn't. The two remaining fish showed no signs whatever that they even knew they had lost the third fish, their friend. No remorse, no sadness, nothing. They swam around. That night I woke up at 3 a.m., went over to the fish barrel, and there they were at the bottom of the water, the two of them curved up next to one another, spoon fashion, asleep. How sweet. I've learned how to change the water in the barrel. I get the boys to help me. We make a bucket brigade to the bathroom, pouring the foul ammonia-smelling water into the bathtub, then using a hose attached to the spigot, snake down the hall and into the bedroom to the barrel, fill it. What the fish think getting dumped back into a clean barrel, I could not tell you. If goldfish grow to the size of the container they are in, why aren't there monster goldfish in the ocean? My friend has been gone 4 months. When she gets home, she says she is going to move back here someday. And if she does, I will ask her. It's nice having fish, I think.